عقبه وبركاته. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الصلاة والسلام على سيدنا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. All praise due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Lord of the world, whose mercy and guidance we seek. And may Allah's peace and blessings be among the last and the seal of all the prophets and messengers of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his family, companions, and upon whoever followed his footsteps to the day of judgment. Welcome back to today's lesson on the explanation of Surah Maryam. But before delving into today's verse, I'm going to say why I recited in Fajr with these two surahs of As-Sajda and Al-Insan. It was the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to recite with the entire surah of As-Sajda in the first rak'ah, fi salati Fajr, in the Fajr prayer on Friday. And in the second rak'ah, he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to recite the entire surah, the entire chapter of Al-Insan. So this is the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So that's why I didn't recite today from Surah Maryam, and I recited instead from Surah Al-Sajda, Al-Sajda, and Surah Al-Insan. And by the way, the Quran contains what is called by Muslim scholars as the verses of when one recites them, he should prostrate down. He should, or it is recommended for him to prostrate down. We have 17 verses in the Quran in that way. 17 verses in the Quran in that way. For example, كَلَّا لَا تُطِعْهُ وَاسْجُدْ وَاقْتَرِبْ فَاسْجُدُوا لِلَّهِ وَاعْبُدُوا فَالَّذِينَ عِنْدَ رَبِّكَ لَا يَسْتَكْبِرُونَ عَنْ عِبَادَتِهِ وَيُسَبِّحُونَهُ وَلَهُ يَسْجُدُونَ إِنَّمَا يُؤْمِنُ بِآيَاتِنَا الَّذِينَ إِذَا ذُكِّرُوا بِهَا خَرُّوا سُجَّدًا. These verses, when a Muslim recites in the Quran, he is recommended to make prostration sujood to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So inshallah for today's verse number 4. كَافَ يَا عَيِّنْ صَادْ ذِكْرُ رَحْمَةِ رَبِّكَ عَبِدَهُ زَكَرِيَّا إِذْ نَادَى رَبَّهُ نِدَاءً خَفِيَّا قَالَ رَبِّ إِنِّي وَهَنَ الْعَظْمُ مِنِّي قَالَ رَبِّ إِنِّي وَهَنَ الْعَظْمُ مِنِّي واشتعل الرأس شيبا. ولم أكن بدعائك رب شقيا. So this is the statement of Prophet Zechariah. We said yesterday that he made supplication to his Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala. And yesterday we highlighted the etiquettes of making dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and said that if anyone wants to make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he should perform ablution in the very beginning. Then he should face the Qibla. After that, he should raise his hands to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as if he's begging to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give him whatever he wants. After that, he should start with praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, mentioning his glory, mentioning his praise subhanahu wa ta'ala. After that, he should make salah on the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. After that, he should ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala whatever he wants, okay? And he should end and conclude his dua and supplication with salah on the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And I told you a very important point, which is that the acceptance of dua is suspended. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not accept it until man makes salah on the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Until one makes salah on the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And a very important point also for the acceptance of dua is that one's food, one's drinking, one's clothes must be from lawful sources. From lawful sources. إِنَّ اللَّهَ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَىٰ أَمَرَ الْمُتَّقِينَ بِمَا أَمَرَ بِهِ الْمُرْسَلِينَ فَقَالَ يَا أَيُّهَا الرُّسُلُ كُلُوا مِنَ الطَّيِّبَاتِ. All messengers, all believers, okay, eat good deeds, eat lawful food. كُلُوا مِنَ الطَّيِّبَاتِ and make good deeds. So, if anyone earn his money from a lawful source and make supplication to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will never ever accept his dua. Allah will never ever accept his dua. So this is a very important point. And that's why Sa'd ibn Abi Waqqas, this great companion, was one of the senior companions of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Sa'd ibn Abi Waqqas. Sa'd was the first one, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to call him, this is my maternal uncle. So the Prophet ﷺ loved him very much. Sa'd once asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, O Messenger of God, ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to immediately answer my call, to answer my call. Whenever I supplicate for him to grant me something, he subhanahu wa ta'ala shall answer my call. So the Prophet said to him, O Sa'ad, eat from local resources and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will grant you what you want. So this is a very important one. Today, Prophet Zakariya said, قال رب إني وهن العظم مني واشتعل الرأس شيبا ولم أكن بدعائك رب شقيا. Prophet Zakariya, as I told you, was very, very old. Was very old. He didn't have a child. And so was his wife. She was very old. And she was barren. She was barren, unable to give birth to children. So that's why he made dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in secret. And this is his dua. This is the statement he said to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is the statement he said to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قَالَ رَبِّ إِنِّي وَهَنَ الْعَظْمُ مِنِّي وَاشْتَعَلَ الرَّأْسُ شَيْبًا وَلَمْ أَكُمْ بِدُعَائِكَ رَبِّ شَقِيًّا. And as I told you, the most dua mentioned in the Quran starts with the word رَبْ. With the word رَبْ. رَبَّنَا لَا تُزِغْ قُلُوبَنَا بَعْدَ إِذْ هَدَيْتَنَا وَهَبْ لَنَا مِنْ لَدُنْكَ رَحْمَةً إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ الْوَهَّابُ. ربنا هب لنا من ازواجنا وذرياتنا قرة اعين واجعلنا للمتقين اماما. ربنا اننا سمعنا مناديا ينادي للايمان ان امنوا بربكم فامنا. That is why some scholars believe the word رب means that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the only Lord that runs the affairs of his creatures. He subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who provides them with food, who provides them with health, who provides them with money, who provides them with offspring. He subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who makes everything in the universe subservient to them. The sun is created for the benefit of the son of Adam. The moon is created for the benefit of the son of Adam. The earth is created and made like that for the benefit of the son of Adam. So are the stars, so are the heaven, so are the animals. So these are so many blessings from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon mankind. Prophet Zakariya said to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, my Lord, Lord, إني وهن العظم مني إني وهن العظم مني. My bone became weak. واشتعل الرأس شيبا. And my head has felt filled with white. So, he made an introduction to his dua. So, and this is a very important point. How smart believer, male or female, knows how to urge Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, how to make Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala answer his dua. I'm going to tell you a very impressive situation from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You know the battle of Badr, right? The battle of Badr. When did it take place, the battle of Badr? This is a very important point concerning how to urge Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala answer your dua. The battle of Badr, this is concerned the criterion, the most important battle of Islam. Badr al-Kubra, the great battle of Badr. It took place in the second year after Hijrah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Battle of Badr. You know, the number of the Muslim army, how many was the soldiers with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in that army? Do you know? 313 or 317. So, say 313, 17 or 15 or 17.
according to some scholars.
Okay.
Do you know how many was the army of the disbelievers?
5,000.
No, not 5,000. It's about 20,000, but 950. 950. Okay. So the number of the disbeliever army is larger than that of the Muslims. So when the Prophet ﷺ made supplication to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he ﷺ said a very impressive statement. He said, "Oh Allah, if this group of Muslims was defeated today, you will never ever be worshipped in that land." So he ﷺ knew fully well how to urge Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant them victory. "Oh Allah, if this small group of believers was defeated today, you will never ever be worshipped in that land. Allahumma in tahlak hadhihi al-isabatu al-yawm falan tu'bada fi hadhihi al-ardi abada." So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala granted him victory. So the same case here with Prophet Zechariah. "Oh my Lord, oh my Lord, my boon became weak." So as long as boon became weak and his head has been filled with white hair, this means that he became very old. And you know that when people are very old, it's very difficult for them to give birth to children, right or not? So this number one. قَالَ رَبِّ إِنِّي وَهْنَ الْعَظْمُ مِنِّي وَاشْتَعَلَ الرَّأْسُ شَيْبًا. Zechariah here did not mention that when he making dua, he did not mention that his wife was barren. Who told that his wife was barren, wasn't able to give birth to children? Because she spent with him a very long period of time and they both didn't give birth to children. But this is the true believer. The true believer should never ever be disappointed, because he knows that there is a Lord. Allah is his Lord. He subhanahu wa ta'ala is fully able to change, to radically and categorically change his condition. His condition in a blink of an eye. قُلِ اللَّهُمَّ مَالِكَ الْمُلْكِ قُلِ اللَّهُمَّ مَالِكَ الْمُلْكِ. So, Zechariah alayhi salam says to his Lord, وَهَنَ الْعَظْمُ مِنِّي وَاشْتَعَلَ الرَّأْسُ شَيْبًا. And this is the point. As I told you yesterday, brothers, dua can make miracles. Dua can make miracles. وَلَمْ أَكُمْ بِدُعَائِكَ رَبِّ شَقِيًّا. Meaning that whenever I supplicated to you, you always make me happy. You always make me happy. So, if you read the Quran from its very beginning to its very end, you'd find that prophets of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala used to resort to dua, to supplications, at times of distress, at hard times. Prophet Abraham alayhi salam, father of all the prophets and messengers, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he took his wife Hajar and his son Ismail to Mecca, and Mecca at the time was, there were no vegetables, there were no plants, there was no water, there were no human beings, there were no creatures at all in Mecca. And he said, "Oh Allah, oh my Lord, رَبَّنَا إِنِّي أَسْكَنْتُ مِنْ ذُرِّيَّتِي بِوَادٍ غَيْرِ ذِي زَرْعٍ عِنْدَ بَيْتِكَ الْمُحَرَّمِ رَبَّنَا لِيُقِيمُوا الصَّلَاةَ فَاجْعَلْ أَفْئِدَةً مِنَ النَّاسِ تَهْوِي إِلَيْهِ." He said, "Oh my Lord, I have dwelt, I have placed my offspring, my wife and my son Ishmael, here in that barren valley, in the valley, wherein there is no water, there is no plants, there is nothing at all. رَبَّنَا لِيُقِيمُوا الصَّلَاةِ. Oh Allah, make them establish and offer prayer. فَاجْعَلْ أَفْئِدَةً مِنَ النَّاسِ تَهْوِي إِلَيْهِمْ. And make the hearts of people inclined to them. It is because that dua of Prophet Ibrahim that all of us love to go to Mecca to make Umrah, to make Hajj. Even if you go one time, you want to go the second time. The second time, you want to go the third time. Because of the dua of Abraham alayhi salam. So, This is the importance of that. So, brother, if any of us is in distress, is at hardship, he should not feel disappointed. Why? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is our Lord. And our Lord, Qadir, fully able, Muqtadir, fully able to do anything, subhanahu wa ta'ala. He subhanahu wa ta'ala is fully able to do anything. So this is for today's lesson, inshallah, and for today's verse. قال رب إني وهن العظم مني واشتعل الرأس شيبا ولم أكن بدعائك رب شقيا. Just for any of us, if he wants Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept his dua and answer his call, he should fulfill the conditions and meet the conditions of making dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept his dua. The last very important point, which is that for dua, and this is the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I may ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant me much money, but he subhanahu wa ta'ala didn't give me the money I want. Okay? So, what is my dua? I met all the conditions. So, what is the dua? Yes, great. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us that when any of us makes dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, his dua will make one of three things. His dua will make one of three things. Number one, either Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept that dua. It's okay. I want offspring, his subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you offspring. I want to be recovered, his subhanahu wa ta'ala will make you recover. So that's number one. Number two, he subhanahu wa ta'ala might keep this dua for you as good deeds, and he subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward you for it on the day of judgment. So that's number two. He subhanahu wa ta'ala will keep it for you on the day of judgment. Because as I told you, dua is ibadah. Dua is an act of worship. The Quran says, قُلْ مَا يَعْبَأُ بِكُمْ رَبِّي لَوْلَا دُعَاءُكُمْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will pay you no attention at all unless you make dua to him. So dua is an act of worship. So the second point. The third point, he subhanahu wa ta'ala might ward off posh harm that was about to afflict you with dua. As I told you yesterday, one's dua ascends to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and one's faith comes down to the earth and they meet with each other. So if dua is made sincere, with full sincerity to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, dua will overcome faith and rises to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So don't say, and this is also the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, don't say, oh, I made dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not answer my dua. That's wrong. Whenever you make dua to him subhanahu wa ta'ala will either accept your dua or postpone it for you or keep it for you on the day of resurrection, or he subhanahu wa ta'ala will remove away any harm that was about to afflict you because of that dua. Also, one of the most important points when you are making dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you should be fully convinced that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would accept your dua, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is fully able to answer your call. Don't say, let's try. Yeah, some people say like that. Let's try, I would make dua. So he might accept. No, don't say that. The Prophet ﷺ said, when you make dua, make it when you are fully convinced that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to answer your dua. His subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to answer your dua. So this is for the etiquette of dua, and this is for today's explanation of verse number 4. Any question? Yes.
What's the best way to make dua?
The best way of making dua, I told the etiquette of making dua. Yesterday, you was absent. Okay? So, when you are going to make dua, perform ablution, face the Qibla, raise your hands to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as if you're begging him like that until your armpits are shown. After that, start with praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and it is very important to ask him subhanahu wa ta'ala with his most beautiful names, Asma Husna, then make salah on the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, then ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala whatever you want, then conclude your dua with supplication with a salah on the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Yeah. Any other question?
Is there one dua?
The best dua is that which is recorded in the Quran. Okay. The best of dua ever is that which is recorded in the Quran. Because Quran is the speech of whom?
Allah.
Of Allah. And the speech of Allah is better than the all other speech of the other speech. Yes. Any other question? So thank you. Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.